Hello and welcome to this premortem of a tool that I will call How to Use String Change Listener. Basically, it's a short demo of me using two or three of my tools. The one here that is allowing to know what the user is copy-pasting, the one that know what the string change was, and basically a little bit of reading the keyboard in Unity, not outside of Unity in this one, and doing action on it. So to give you a bit of an example of what I'm saying by doing action on it, here in this application, if I type Eloi, it allows me to know that I was typing Eloi, and you can see here that I'm listening to two inputs, the input of Unity input, that means what is the user is typing in Unity, and the keyboard input, meaning the type of the real keyboard. But when you type the real keyboard, you don't want to track this one, because it depends on the language of the computer. So here I track only alphanumeric, so A, B, C, 0, 1, space, stuff like this. So what happened is that now that I'm listening to the keyboard of the user, in this demo in Unity, but in my tool on the computer, you can write Eloi, hello. And when you type hello, you can see here that he find that, oh, you mean hello? Okay, I will copy hello in the copy past. So now if I do past, you can see that I have hello in the copy past of the user. So what this tool demo of the tool mean is that you can listen to the clipboard and listen to the keyboard of the user, try to guess what he wants based on the file he give you, and convert that to an action or convert that to a copy past more easy for the guy. For example, when I say action, if I do google.unity like this and I copy paste, what happened is that he opened me Unity, it opened me Google with Unity in it. If I do translate war like this, I copy paste and it opened me a Google traduction a war. So basically that's what I'm trying to do with this small demo, is to show the power of doing that, to be able to use it in my other tool. Okay, so how do you do that if you want to copy what I've done here and you don't want to use the better one I will code in the future? I will show you. So basically here I have a copy past instance that allow me to know if there is some change in the copy past. And what happened is that I'm listening to it, but I'm also listening to a version here, listen to clip copy path with break. It means that if I'm modifying the copy path, I'm able to put the listener in break, in pause, because I don't want to have infinite loop where the copy path change and so the code do something and then put in the copy path and the copy path change and etc. etc. You see the problem. So here I'm just listening to change, except if I say I don't want to listen to change. Okay? In the other one here, it's a simulator of using the input of Unity and using the keystroke of Unity to be able to influence here a continuous char string listener. So basically it means that it records every input and it records only the 20 last one, because I don't have to listen to all the input the user is writing, just the last part. And when it changes, it's try to call someone. And if we look at who he is calling here, he is calling a clipboard here and string relay. And this one will check if the input that has been changed and by. And if I press play, ta-ta-da. Here, ta-ta-ta. Does it end by hello or does it end by password? If yes, could you replace it by this password or could you replace it by hello world? Okay, so that's what's happening. As you can see here, the keyboard one will speak to the end string relay and the clipboard one will more speak about exact string relay. So the N1 check about the end, the extract check about if it's exactly this char. And as you can see here, we have a small difference, is that I firstly send the input to open wet string relay, because I want to check if I need to open a Windows or to convert it. So here, basically, it will try to check. We can see the code if you want. I just checking, is the text that the user is giving me looking to this or this or this? If yes, call this website or this website with those data. Okay. And if he don't find it, he will call the translator of the exact word. So he'll try to find if it look like exactly those one. If it's not exactly those one, he will call this one. It is called no take in charge. And this one can be given to any application, any following code you want. For example, you can try to translate it with regex or translate it based on another database. And if you can translate it, good. If not, you do the same stuff, so you give it to someone else, extra, extra, extra. I have another code that is not clean yet, that is very more well done compared to that. But that's a good demo of how it can work. And when it happened, for example, when he wants to say, okay, I want to put that in the clipboard of the user. So it's ending by hello. When it's ending by hello, I want to call here clipboard entry string, clipboard. And you can see here that in the clipboard, I don't contact directly clipboard because I need to first make it a pause, make a break to avoid looping. So I just say, hey, could you put copy past listener to break for 1 second? Could you put the text here to what I'm copying, pasting to be able to inform the guy that it's okay, I've understood it. And after that, could you put it in the in the clipboard of Windows by using this class? And tada! Basically, that's all. It's just a demo of how you can use two or three packages to be able to do this kind of tool that convert a clipboard to something else. It's very, very dangerous if you want to hack someone, because don't forget that the clipboard is accessible by everybody. So if someone has a virus that is checking to the clipboard and you put some password in it, it could be bad. But it's not my problem, because I mean, your computer should not have a virus tracking every move you do. Okay, but don't forget that it could be a secure failure if you do this kind of application, and don't take that in consideration. On that, I finished this pre-mortem of this tool that is just an archive of and documentation about this code. It will probably become obsolete really quickly. So in the description, I will put the link of the previous Git and the Git revision with it to say it worked with this old code. But maybe it will work in the future, I don't know. On that, I hope it was useful to you. Feel free to watch the code and look how I've done it to do it yourself if you want to do this kind of application. May the code be with you. See you later. Bye.